I will never forget the 5th of August, where the highest level of immaturity was demonstrated by some of the candidates by trying to deny me access to a presidential platform. Poor Kalonzo shouting, "Order!" You don't shout order, you take leadership. They thought it was okay. The whole world sympathized. The whole world gave me a feedback. That when the only reason Joho could have done that is appreciation that Raila condones that type of politics. It is appreciation that violence pays, that impunity is not punished in this country. Nonetheless, we went into the election, and I feel that the election outcome, as much as I was in the initial onset, one of those who was set to accept the outcome, I want to appreciate the evidence that came to us ultimately. And if nobody else had the courage to take up this matter, I have the courage. You know, they say sometimes you live to fight another day. Sometimes you live to fight now. And that's what I have decided to do. I will challenge this process. We have challenged this process. We have some of the best lawyers who are going to prosecute this matter. And one of our prayers this time is that those who are found culpable must be punished for criminal offenses. There has been too much theft in the election and the subversion of this process in this county for too long. And in our petition, for those who might have read it online, it avers a number of other grounds. Abuse of public resources, state officers taking part in an election, among other issues that I spoke to within the petition, including education, that the current governor does not qualify to hold that position, even if he subverts the process of illegality through the courts. Ultimately, time will catch up with him. So for me, as a conscious call, it is only imperative. You know, I hear the Joho followership asking, how does the number three go to court? It's not about the number three, it's just that the number one is not deserving. It's not also about the number three, or the 40,000 plus votes that I have, 44,000. Even a voter on his own accord can decide to petition a process that they think is not free and fair. So on behalf of those people who have courage, and I think for us, our struggle is a continuous effort. It's a continuous getting up and living to fight and fighting back. We are like heavyweight boxers. You take some punches and you get up and you come and get some more and still come up and approach that fight until victory. So I think that was a small event, was a slip, was not a collapse. And what for me was most persuading was the reference of Mombasa's irregularity in the Supreme Court and the initial people who gave us evidence that there was tampering of results in Mombasa and the electoral process was fraudulent was none other than NASA itself. For them to turn around, as they say it on pulpits, woe unto you hypocrites. So we will pursue this. Mombasa should be bracing for a by-election that will actually administer the true will of the people. I am not going to discuss the merits and demerits because the matter is now duly before the court of law, and I therefore can only talk about the broader context upon which I pursued this matter. I am not a coward. You cannot have such a document where senior lawyers and senior counsels think it's a massively well-written, well-researched document, and then not have the gut to present it before a forum that could prosecute this matter conclusively. So I think we need electoral justice so that next time, hata wewe, Brian, hata wewe, Jacob, hata anybody else, mukedaka election, sio wewe mfanya bidii, mwingine atia a ballot staff. It was all of you, even in terms of your logic, know that the results do not make sense. The results do not fit in.